Hi students, in this class we learn about electric field and find what is the unit of electric field. Okay, let us start. Right, see, we studied Coulomb's law. It states that force between the two charges is directly proportional to the magnitude of charge 1, magnitude of charge 2, and inversely proportional to the square of the distance. But the question arises, how does first charge knows the presence of second charge? We found the force between these two, but how charge 1 knows Q1 knows Q2 is present, or Q2 knows Q1 is present, right? How does one charge knows the presence of other? That question is not answered by Coulomb's law. Right, so if you want to find the answer for that question, we have to know the concept of electric field. Right, it is a vector quantity. Okay, so that is the significance of electric field. Right, okay, so electric field, field is a word introduced by Michael Faraday. He only first used the term field. Right, so this is very, very important Faraday. Okay, right, we will see that. Right, so before that, we have to see the difference between electrostatic force and mechanical force. We know electrostatic force Fe is equal to this one, right, and magnetic force, electromagnetic force, simply we can call both electric force and magnetic force as EM force, electromagnetic force. There is a huge difference between electromagnetic force and mechanical force, right? Hope you have seen this experiment that we did in our childhood. What we do, we have a two magnet, we bring a magnet to from some long distance when it is coming, right? Once it crosses certain region, for example, let us see. Okay, this is the best way. Okay, once it crosses a particular region, this region, let us assume this region, right? Until you bring here, the second magnet will not feel anything. But once it reaches this region, it will go and touch, connect with the first magnet. Clear or not? Okay, right? So here, it doesn't feel anything. Here, it doesn't feel anything. But once it crosses some region, boundary, the second magnet is attracted towards first magnet, even though if you leave your hands, they will automatically attract each other because opposite poles attract each other. But how does this magnet knows this fellow is coming? That is the question. Same question arises here, right? But without touching, they knows and attract. Even if you don't bring closer to them, these two magnets attracts. That's what magnetic force. They don't need to touch each other. Similarly, we studied same charges repel and opposite charges attract, our electrostatic force. That force also don't need to touch each other. That's what we know as action at distance. Action at distance. Either repulsion or attraction takes place at the distance itself. Right? Suppose if you bring your magnet from here, once it crosses this region, either it will be attracted or repelled in this region. You don't need to bring closer and touch. But in mechanical force, for example, someone wants to apply brake, right? So what he has to do, he has to press the brake by using his leg. Both brake and leg should touch, right? Here we cannot simply keep my leg here and simply say brake means it won't stop. Right, so here it is not action at distance. So mechanical force is not action at distance, whereas our electrostatic force is a action at distance. That word is very, very important. No need to touch. We have known that two positive charges repel each other, two negative charges repel each other, positive and negative charges, opposite charges attract each other, but they don't need to touch each other for either repulsion or attraction. That is what due to the field. Let us see and introduce the concept of field now, right? So let us assume I have a charge Q here, right? So Faraday told every charge produces some field surrounding it, right? So this charge produces some field like this. This is field, right? So in this field we bring one test charge small q in this field. Okay, so how does this test charge knows, or how does this is source charge. Let us assume this is source of a field. It is test charge, right? So how does this source know somebody is present? It spreads the field, right, and applies the force, right? So then these two charges interact. As per Coulomb's law, we know that the force between the two charges is given by K into first charge Q and into second charge divided by distance squared R squared, right? So the charge, both Q and small q, feel the force from the field. So how the process is carried out? A charge, that is source charge, produces field. This field produces force. Thus, that force is felt by test charge. In this way, two charges know the presence of each other, right? So this is the sequence. Okay. So field is an important term. So now we define what is the field. So let us assume this charge. What is my test charge? Okay, right. My test charge is located here. For example, the point is P, right? So what is the electric field? Electric field at point P is given by force felt by a test charge. Force felt by a unit test charge Q, because test charge is small q, right? So what is the force? We know that force is given by force is equal to, already we found here, right? Force is given by, let us assume vector quantity, so we put r cap. So what is force? Force is K into Q by R squared R cap divided by Q, the small q. Q, Q cancel. So what is the electric field? Electric field is given the notation E vector is equal to F by Q, that is equal to K Q by R squared R cap, where K is same 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. See, F is a scalar, we know. Q is a vector. F is a vector, Q is a scalar. Vector divided by scalar is also a vector. That's why electric field is a vector. It has both magnitude and direction. So, KQ by R squared is the magnitude of electric field. Unit vector gives the direction of electric field, right? So the electric field felt at particular point P is given by KQ by R squared R cap, right? So now we see the unit. Okay, right? So what is the unit? We know E is equal to F by Q. What is the unit of force? The unit of force is Newton. Unit of charge is Coulomb. So electric field has a unit of Newton per Coulomb. Okay. But in real time, we use the one more important unit, that is volt per meter, which is widely used in the real time. Right. So the unit of electric field is either Newton per Coulomb you use or volt per meter you can use. Right. So that's all about this session. If you are having any doubt, please ask me in comment section. I will clarify all your doubts. Thank you.